Hi, let's talk about the right atrium. In this video, we'll discuss the unique structures of the right atrium. The right atrium, as you recall, is the recipient of all of the blood coming back from systemic circulation. So it's going to receive blood from the superior vena cava, the inferior vena cava, and the coronary sinus, which is serving the heart. The region into which these vessels drain is called the sinus venarum, and it's very smooth-walled. So we can see precisely how smooth-walled this is along these sides, not rugose at all. We can contrast that from the anterior portion of the atria, which has ridges in it. These ridges are pectinate muscle, so the myocardium is pushing the endocardium inward to form these ridges. And this region is separated from the sinus venarum by the crista terminalis. So if we were to kind of move that flap back, we would see that the crista terminalis is running right around there. At the superior margin of the crista terminalis, there is a collection of specialized cardiomyocytes called the sinoatrial node, or the SA node. This is known as the pacemaker region of the heart, and it's what the cardiac plexuses are going to work upon to alter heart rate. Now, between this, the right, and deep to this, the left atrium, there is an interatrial septum, or a wall that divides the two atria. And we can see here and here, there is a very fragile or thin part to that septum called the fossa ovalis. The fossa ovalis is a remnant of a fetal structure called the foramen ovale, where there were two septa and a patency between them. That space between them is called the foramen ovale, and it represents a pathway of blood that in utero can go from the inferior vena cava through the right atrium to the left atrium and then out through the left ventricle aortic valve. So it shortcuts pulmonary circulation. There's no need to send oxygen-rich blood to the lungs because the lungs aren't serving as an organ of respiration at that point. We can see there's a ridge here, and that ridge corresponds to the division between the right atrium and the right ventricle. So the tricuspid valve is going to be anchored within that ridge. But we can also see the opening to the coronary sinus, which would be there. There's the ridge. The opening would be approximately there. And just superior to that, kind of at the nexus of the atrioventricular septum and the interatrial septum, we have another collection of specialized cardiomyocytes called the atrioventricular node, or the AV node for short. That AV node is going to be a coordination center for the depolarization of cardiomyocytes as they transcend that atrioventricular septum, or the fibrous skeleton of the heart. Now, here is a view of the atria with the walls of the atria removed, as well as that septum. So there would be the interatrial septum. And we can see the orifice for the tricuspid valve. That tricuspid valve gets its name as tricuspid because there are three cusps. There is an anterior cusp, a posterior cusp, and a septal cusp. That septal cusp is largely immobile, so it doesn't move during the opening and closing of the valve. I'll point this out to you. We haven't quite covered it in the videos yet, but this is a branch of the right coronary artery, which is coming around here, called the AV nodal branch, because it supplies the atrioventricular node with blood. And we can see it there kind of at the nexus of the atrioventricular septum and the interatrial septum as well. So we've discussed the peculiarities of features to the right atrium. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.